6 Minute English from bbclearningenglish.com.
Hello, this is 6 Minute English from BBC Learning English. I'm Neil.
And I'm Sam. In the UK, there's a well-known children's game called Happy Families. Players have to collect all the cards belonging to one family. There's a butcher, a baker, a carpenter, a doctor, and a tailor. Some of the traditional jobs that people in the UK have been doing for centuries.
But since the invention of the internet and social media, a more up-to-date list of jobs in the 21st century would be very different. It would include modern jobs which didn't exist before, online jobs like web designer and YouTuber.
One of the most unusual of these new digital jobs is the influencer, someone who is paid by a company to promote their brand on social media, encouraging people to buy their products. In this program, we'll meet two beauty influencers from different parts of the world, Nigeria and Pakistan. We'll discover how these women are using their online influence to change attitudes towards female beauty. And as usual, we'll learn some related vocabulary too.
But first, I have a question for you, Sam. YouTube makeup tutorials are very modern, but makeup has been around for a long time. So when was lipstick first used? Was it A, around 3,000 years ago by the ancient Celts? B, around 4,000 years ago by the ancient Egyptians? Or C, around 5,000 years ago by the ancient Sumerians?
I'll say it was being used 5,000 years ago by the ancient Sumerians.
Okay, Sam, we'll find out if you're right later on. Dima Ume is a beauty influencer from Nigeria. She's been creating makeup video tutorials for women of colour for 8 years and has hundreds of thousands of followers. Her videos go from eyebrow-shaping tips to shopping trips in Nigeria's bigger city, Lagos.
Here's Dima telling BBC World Service programme The Conversation how her life as an influencer got started.
So I did a makeup do's and don'ts video in 2017. I had seen a couple of people do it prior to that, but then, you know, I kind of did it in a way that was a bit funny, maybe cracked a couple of jokes around the ways or the maybe not so great ways some people were doing things at the time. And that video just took off.
In 2017, Dima made a YouTube video of makeup do's and don'ts, rules about what to do and what not to do in a certain situation or when doing a certain activity.
Dima wasn't the first Nigerian influencer to post videos on YouTube, but the difference was her humour, the way she laughed and cracked or told jokes. More and more people started watching Dima's makeup videos and they soon took off, meaning they suddenly became successful and popular.
Our next beauty influencer is Ramal Mehmood, a photographer turned makeup artist based in Islamabad, Pakistan. As well as makeup tips, Ramal creates colourful face painting designs, which, she says, helped her through a period of depression. She has popular Instagram and YouTube accounts on which she shares content to help other women with their confidence and mental health.
Like Dima, Ramal now has Instagram followers numbering in the hundreds of thousands. So how does she decide what to share in her blogs and videos? What boundaries does she set for her followers? Here's what Ramal told BBC World Service programme The Conversation.
Well, people are very intrigued about your personal life as a blogger. That's a given. But you need to have strong boundaries. I do share about my family and friends. You actually have to ask people if they are comfortable being on your platform or not.
Ramal says her followers are intrigued about her personal life. If you're intrigued, you're very interested in someone, often because of something unusual or unexpected about them.
Ramal accepts that her followers' interest in her personal life is a given, something that is considered to be a fact or that is certain to happen. For example, you could say, it's a given that there will be champagne at a typical British wedding, meaning it's certain, it's a fact, there will be champagne.
But just because her followers' interest in her life is a given, that doesn't mean Ramal shares everything with them. she has to set boundaries.
Both Dima and Ramal make money as beauty influencers, but what's amazing is how they're using social media to start conversations about what beauty means to women in their country and sharing some great lipstick tips as well.
And speaking of lipstick, let's reveal the answer to my question, Sam. I asked you when lipstick was first used.
I said it was around 5,000 years ago by the ancient Sumerians.
Which was the correct answer. Ancient Sumerians, both men and women, painted their faces, eyes and lips. A very early kind of lipstick. Okay, let's recap the vocabulary from this program on influencers. People who influence their social media followers to try different products.
Do's and don'ts are rules about what you should and shouldn't do in certain situations.
To crack a joke means to tell a joke.
The phrasal verb take off means to suddenly become popular or successful.
If you are intrigued, you are interested in someone, often because of something unusual about them.
And finally, a given describes something that is considered to be a fact or that is certain to happen.
Once again, our 6 minutes are up. Goodbye for now.
Bye-bye.
6 Minute English from the BBC.